today, and I know you're going to enjoy this presentation. Pierce Pettis is one of the foremost songwriters, musicians, and talents in Nashville and in our country today. We are so honored to have him on the show, and sit back, relax, and enjoy.
Hi, this is Pierce Pettis. Welcome to my home here on Lookout Mountain. Just want to say thank you for listening to my music, and I'm honored to be featured on American Jamboree. I think I'm supposed to say some encouraging things, so here goes. You know, we've all been under a lot of stress. This has been a really, really tough year. And as I look around, I see a lot of friends coming apart, a lot of friendships being destroyed, even families and marriages, and a lot of it over politics. And to me, that's kind of tragic, you know, because it seems to me that politics is a poor exchange for a friendship or a family member. And so if I were to give advice, not that I'm qualified to give advice, but if I were, I would say, don't be the kind of person who'd rather lose a friend than an argument. Just let it go, man, because we really need our friends and families around us right now, even if we don't always agree.
Let it pour, let it rain a whole lot more, 'cause I got them deep rubber blues. Let the rain drive right on, let the waves sweep along, 'cause I got them deep rubber blues. Mr. Zeidman wore long sleeves to keep an ugly thing from view. Not a birthmark on his arm or a circus tattoo. No one ever asked about it. No one ever knew the terrible secrets of our one and only Jew. Mr. tailor's shop in a small town. Well, that's where he lived and worked. Used to go there with my mother, and I hid behind her skirt. But he had a smile for every child and a piece of candy too. Why, there was kindness in the hands of our one and only Jew. It was a beautiful world. It was a beautiful time for a boy and a girl in the prime of their lives. Him and look, baby smiles. He looks so much like you. In the spring of 39, how the apple blossoms bloomed. Mr. Zeidman sold his store when his work was finally done, for a condo in Miami to enjoy the setting sun. And then came rumors of a fatal jump. I pray that not true. The memories I carry are the memories I choose. And tonight I'll light a candle for our one and only Jew. It was a beautiful world. It was a beautiful time for a boy and a girl in the prime of their lives. Haven look, baby smiles. He looks so much like you. In the spring of 39, how the apple blossoms.
I should mention this next song is a title song from my most recent album. It's called Father's Son, and it also has a Georgia connection. I wrote this with Pat Walsh. He's a wonderful guy. Pat's from Augusta, Georgia. One of those descended from one of them Irishmen that the English put in this prison colony called Georgia. You may be familiar with that story. I don't know. Though you're weary and worried, though you stumble and fall, surrounded by trouble, with your back to the wall, when you're busted and broken, remember the one that you'll always be, your father's son. When you're brought down in hatred, when you're brought down by love, brought down by those things you just can't rise above. When you stray from the path and hate what you've become, still you remain your father's son. Your father's eyes, your father's name, your father's pride, your father's shame. Be you braggart or humble, be you doctor or thief, if you're made out of money, if you live on relief,
still you cannot escape it. No matter how far you run, oh, you will remain your father's son. Your father's hands, your father's face. So here you stand in your father's place. You may never have known him. You may know him too well. He may have given his blessing. He may have given you hell. But if you know the difference between right and wrong, then don't forget what you are, your father's son. Hey, don't forget who you are, your father's son.
Familiar with St. Francis. He was a cool guy. His name wasn't Francis, by the way. I don't know if you know that. You Catholics here, you might know this. His name was John. Francis was his nickname. Did you know that? And the reason was, back when he lived, you know how teenagers have fads, you know, they're all into things, you know, like the twist or whatever. Well, when he was a young man, French chivalric poetry was all the rage. Everybody, and he was totally into it. He loved all that French stuff. So his friends started calling him Frenchie, Francesco, because he's Italian, right? That's what they called him, Frenchie. So it was really his nickname. But anyway, the song borrows a lot from St. Francis. Let me be an instrument of your peace. Be a tool in your hand. Crooked and warped though I might be, let me do some good here while I can. Let me be a vessel for your grace. Let me be the first one to forgive. Though the world may curse me to my face, let me learn to bear it like you did. Let me be a kindling of your light. Fan the flame until it blazes through. So if anyone should pay me any mind, let them catch a little glimpse of you. Let me grow in love that knows no fear. Till every tear is wiped away. And when the night is drawing near, I can look forward to the day. Faithful, make me grateful.
crooked and warped though I might be. Let me do some good here while I can. Let me do some good here. Thank you so much. Thank you, guys. God bless you. Thank you.
Hey, this is Doug Padgett from Folk Common Good. We are so excited about the American Jamboree because we need a movement of common good in this country, and every movement has a soundtrack. And we invite all of you to help make the soundtrack for a common good movement through American Jamboree.